Hi, I'm Nick Deverell-Smith and this is for Off The Block. The Churchill Arms in Paxford is a boutique pub. We've got four letting bedrooms and we try and deliver good pub food. Our philosophy is to source the very, very best and put that out there with, you know, with our little touches. I'm classically trained. I work for Gordon Ramsey, Mark Appeal White, Eric Chavotat, and then took Michelin Star food quality into the pub environment. And I give people, you know, the best gammon and eggs, the best shepherd's pie, and best beef Wellington. We do the classics, but really, really well. How beef works with us here is we do anything from obviously the fillet, and then we have, for instance, the pies. We're doing lovely beef pie with maybe our house ale that we do here called Winston. You know, really slow cook that, get it really sticky and tasty. And then we build that within our pies, and we also do a Sunday lunch. So we'll use the rumps for that. We're trying to make the whole use of the whole carcass from, you know, from the key parts of the fillet and the Chateaubriand down to the, you know, the rump and the offcut. So yeah, we're using the whole animal. So the dish I'm gonna do for you today is a beef Wellington. So this dish means an awful lot to me. I knew I probably wanted to be a chef. 8-10 years old, my mum and my grandma were fantastic cooks, real home cooks, you know. And special occasion, beef Wellington, the whole fillet, it was done well by my mum, and I knew that if I was going to bring it into my world and my chefy world, that it had to be amazing. So I've taken something that was brilliant as a childhood memory to me, to, you know, sitting on the Rolls Royce on my menu. To start off the dish, we take a 16 ounce fillet of beef, we call it the Chateaubriand, and how we do that is we're going to sear it off, and then once we've got that nice caramelisation, just some nut brown butter, finish with a bit of thyme and garlic just to give it that little extra flavour. Good 2 or 3 minutes on each side, so that should take, you know, 4 or 5 minutes, get a really nice colour around it, and then we put that to one side, allow it to cool down, and then we finish it with a bit of English mustard and horseradish just to add an extra seasoning. And then we move on to the duxelle mix. We've got a mushroom pate that just goes around the beef. We blitz the mushrooms. You can chop them by hand, but we find it works better for us if we blitz them straight into the nut brown butter and give it a real fry. The fryingness gives, same as the beef, that caramelization of the mushroom is where the flavor comes from. A handful of breadcrumbs, again, a little squeeze of mustard, some tarragon to finish. It takes about 20 minutes from start to finish. So get really nice colour on the mushrooms, releasing all the water out, because we don't want the water to steam the beef. We're trying to roast it, and then we pull that off, allow it to cool, and then to build the Wellington, if you must. We wrap the mushroom around the beef, allow it to cool, and then we have some beautiful puff pastry, put it into the Wellington, if you will. So once the Wellington is built and we've got a beautiful egg wash shine on it, into the oven, and we take it to 38 degrees, which is rare to medium rare. And then that is about 28 to 30 minutes. Classically, we serve it on a board and we allow the guests to choose the side to come with it. It's the showstopper. So when this comes through the restaurant, the aroma, the smell, and, you know, someone's bringing the, you know, the main event to the table, and people really buy into that. Theatre is, you eat with your eyes. So today with it, I'm gonna serve with you a truffle macaroni. Super indulgent, rich, full of flavour, the ultimate Moorish heaven. So the standard of the produce is absolutely vital. You know, you can't start off with something that's totally rubbish and turn it into something that is beautifully amazing. My relationship with my suppliers, you know, my beef farmer, it's the first thing you do as a chef. You build that relationship before you open to your customers. You find out how he looks after his animals, what the process is he uses, so that you work with that. And he tells you, this is how we do it, this is what we do. And that gives us the head start that we need to think, right, this is what I need to do now. We're at this stage, and that's what makes our relationship very, very special.